तस्य भाषा सर्वमिदं विभाति श्री नित्यानन्देश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवाय नमः नानाविध दीपोपचारार्थे महामंगल नीराजनं सन्दर्शयामि ओम दशांगं गुग्गुलोपेतं सुगंधं च सुमनोहरं आग्रेय सर्वदेवानां धूपोऽयं प्रतिगृह्यतां श्री नित्यानन्देश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवाय नमः धूपमाघ्रापयामि ओम साज्यं त्रिवर्ति संयुक्तं मन्हिना योजितं मया ग्रहाणमंगलं दीपं त्रैलोक्यतिमिरापहम् श्री नित्यानन्देश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवाय नमः दीपं दर्शयामि त्रैवेद्यं अमृते अमृतोद्भवे अमृतवर्षिणी अमृतं श्रावय श्रावय स्वाहा श्री नित्यानन्देश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवाय नमः नैवेद्यं निवेदयामि ॐ तत्पुरुषाय विद्महे महादेवाय धीमहि तन्नो रुद्र प्रचोदयात् श्री नित्यानन्देश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवाय नमः कर्पूर नीराजनं सन्दर्शयामि रक्षां धारयामि ॐ योपां पुष्पं वेद पुष्पवान् प्रजावान् पशुमान् भवति चंद्रमा वा अपां पुष्पं पुष्पवान् प्रजावान् पशुमान् भवति य एवं वेद योपामायतनं वेद आयतनवान् भवति वेदोक्तमन्त्रपुष्पाञ्जलिं समर्पयामि The next offering as a part of the Uttamottama Seva is the offering of the Chaturvedam. Deva Devottama Devata Sarvabhauma Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Chaturveda Priya Chaturveda Pavadharaya हरिः ॐ रात्रिव्यख्यदायति पुरुत्रा देव्या अक्षभिः विश्वा अधिश्रियोधिता हरिः ॐ हरिः ॐ सहस्रशीर्षा पुरुषः सहस्राक्षः सहस्रपात् स भूमिं विश्वतो वृत्वा अत्यतिष्ठद्दशाङ्गुलम् हरिः ॐ हरिः ॐ अग्न आयाहि वीतये घृणानो हव्यदातये निहोता सत्सि बर्हिः हरिः ॐ हरिः ॐ षण्णो देवी रभिष्टय आपो भवन्तु पीतये संयोरभिस्रवन्तु नः हरिः ॐ The next offering is a part of the Uttamottam Seva, is the offering of the Agama Shlokas. Devadevottama Devata Sarvabhauma Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Agama Shloka Priya Agama Shloka Navadharaya Kvachid Vastuni Vinyasya Shanair Drishtim Nivartayet Tajnanam Chitta Sahitam Devi Shunyalayo Bhavet. The next offering is a part of the Uttamottam Seva, is the offering of the Stotras. Deva Devottama Devata Sarvabhauma Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva. Stotra Priya Stotra Mabadharaya Duswapna Dushakuna Durgati Dormanasya Durbhiksha Durvyasana Dussaha Duryashamsi Utpata Tapa Vishabhiti Masat Graharti Vyadhim Shchanashayatu Mejagata Madhishaha Om Namo Bhagavate Sadashivaya Sakala Dattvatmakaya Sarva Mantra Swarupaya Sarva Yantra Dhishtitaya Sarvatantra Swarupaya Sarvatattva Viduraya
Brahmarudravatarine Nilakanthaya Parvati Manoharaya Soma Suryagni Lochanaya Vasmo Dhulita Vigrahaya Mahamani Mukutadharanaya Manikya Bhushanaya Shrishti Sthiti Pralaya Kala Raudravataraya Dakshadvara Dvamshakaya Mahakala Vedanaya Mooladharaika Nilayaya Tattvadhitaya Gangadharaya Sarvadevadidevaya Sadashrayaya
Vedantasaraya
Trivarga Sadhanaya Anantakoti Brahmandanayakaya Vasuki Dakshakakar Kotaka Shankakulika Padma Mahapadme Tyashtamahanaga Kulabhushanaya Pranavaswarupaya
Chidakashaya Akashadikswarupaya
Grahanakshatramaline
Sakalaya Kalankarahitaya Sakala Lokaika Kartre Sakala Lokaika Bhartre Sakala Lokaika Samhartre Sakala Lokaika Gurave Sakala Lokaika Sakshire
Sakala Nigamagukhyaya Sakala Vedantaparagaya Sakala Lokaika Varapradaya Sakala Lokaika Shankaraya
Shashanka Shekharaya
Shashvatanjavasaya
Nirabhasaya
Niramayaya
Nirmalaya Nirlobhaya Nirmadaya Nishchintaya Nirahankaraya Nirankushaya Nishkalankaya Nirgunaya Nishkamaya Nirubhadravaya Nirabhadyaya Nirantaraya Nishkaranaya Nirantakaya Nishprapanchaya Nishsangaya Nirdvandvaya Niradharaya Niragaya Nishkrodhaya Nirmalaya Nishpapaya Nirbhayaya Nirvikalpaya Nirbhedaya Nishkriyaya Nistulaya Nishamshayaya Niranjanaya Nirupama Vibhavaya Nitya Shuddha Buddha Paripurna Satchidananda Advayaya
Paramashanta Swarupaya Tejo Rupaya Tejo Mayaya Jaya Jaya Rudra Maharaudra Bhadravatara Mahabhairava Kalabhairava Kalpantabhairava Kapala Maladhara
Khatvanga Khatga Charma Pashankushata Murushula Chapa Banaga Dashakti Bhindi Pala Tomara Musala Mudgara Pasha Parika Bhushundi Shatagni
Chakratyayudha Bhishanagara Sahasramukutam Shrakarala Vadana Vikatattahasa
Visparita Brahmanda Mandala
Nagendra Kundala,
Nagendra Hara,
Nagendra Valaya, Nagendra Charmadhara,
Mrityunjaya, Trembaka, Tripurantaka, Vishwarupa,
Virupaksha,
Vishveshwara, Vrishabhavahana, Vishabhushana, Vishvato Mukha, Sarvato Raksha Rakshamam, Jwala Jwala, Mahamrityum,
Abamrityu Bhayam Nashaya Nashaya,
Chora Bhayam Utsadaya Utsadaya,
Vishasarpa Bhayam Shamaya Shamaya,
Choran
Maraya Maraya,
Mama Shatrun Utsadaya Utsadaya, Trishulena Vidhaya Vidharaya, Kutharena Bhindi Bhindi, Khatkena Chindi Chindi, Khatvangena Vibodhaya Vibodhaya, Musalena Nishpeshaya Nishpeshaya, Bane Sandadaya Sandadaya,
Rakshamsi Bhishaya Bhishaya,
Bhutani Vidravaya Vidravaya,
Kushmandamaricha Vetala Brahmarakshasa Ganane, Santrasaya Santrasaya, Mam Abhayam Kuru Kuru, Vitrastham Mam, Ashwasaya Ashwasaya, Naraka Bhayam Mam, Uddhara Uddhara, Sanjeevaya Sanjeevaya, Shatrubhyam Mam, Aapyayaya Aapyayaya,
Dukkhaturam
Mam, Anandaya Anandaya,
Shivakamate
Namam, Achhadaya Achhadaya,
Mrityunjaya Trimbaka Sadashiva Namaste Namaste. The next offering is a part of the Uttamottama Seva, is the offering of the Samagana. Deva Devottama Devata Sarvabhauma Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Samagana Priya Samagana Mavadharaya
Etat Samagayannaste Havu 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 Ahamannam 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 Ahamannado Ahamannado Ahamannadaha Ahagslo Gagrida Hagslo Gagrida Hagslo Gagrida Ahamasmi Pradhamajarudasya Purvam Devebhyo Amritasya Nabhai Yoma Dadadi Selevama Vaha Ahamannamannamathantamadmi Aham Vishvam Bhuvanamabhyabhavam Suvarna Jyoti Ihi Harihi Om.
The next offering as a part of the Uttamottama Seva is the offering of the Ghanapata. Deva Devottama Devatas Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Ghanapata Priya Ghanapata Mavadharaya Om Ganana Antwa Twa Ganana Am Ganana Antwa Ganapatim Ganapatim Twa Ganana Antwa Ganana Antwa Ganapatim Twa Ganapatim Ganapatim Twa Twa Ganapati Gum Hava Mahe Ganapati Gum Twa Twa Ganapati Gum Hava Mahe Ganapati Gum Hava Mahe Hava Mahe Ganapati Gum Ganapati Gum Hava Mahe Kavim Kavim Gum Hava Mahe Ganapatim Ganapati Gum Hava Mahe Kavim Ganapati Miti Ganapatim Hava Mahe Kavim Kavigum Hava Mahe Hava Mahe Kavim Kavinang Kavinang Kavigum Hava Mahe Hava Mahe Kavim Kavinang Kavim Kavinang Kavinang Kavim 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 Kavinang Bhuvamashravasta Kavinkavinam kavinam kavim kavim kavinam upamashravastam upamashravastam kavinkavinam kavim kavim kavinam upamashravastam kavinam upamashravastam upamashravastam kavinam kavinam upamashravastam upavashravastam ityupavashramastam harihi om. The next offering as a part of the Uttamottama Seva is the offering of the Dravida Vedam. Deva Devo Uttama Devata Sarva Bhuma Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva. Dravida Veda Priya Dravida Veda Vavadharaya. Shiva Trichitram Balam Mandiramavadinir Vanavarmeladinir Sundaramavadinir Tudirka Padavadinir Tandiramavadinir Samayatilvulladinir Sendumaivayumaipan Gan Tirialavayan Tirinir Shiva Trichitrambalam. The next offering as a part of the Uttamottama Seva is the offering of the Kailaya Vadyam. Deva Devo Uttama Devata Sarva Bhuma Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Kailaya Vadya Priya Kailaya Vadyam Avadharaya.
The next offering, as a part of the Uttamottama Seva, is the offering of the Paramashiva Shakti Avishkarana, the offering of the manifestation of powers at the lotus feet of Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva.
Deva Devottama Devata Sarvabhum Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva. Paramashiva Shakti Avishkarana Priya Paramashiva Shakti Avishkarana Mavadharaya.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Devata Sarvabhumam Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayakam Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashivam Ashtapushpera Bhrecha.
Om Sarvasyapti Sarvasyajitti Sarvamevatena Apnoti Sarvanjayati Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashivaya Namaha Sarvopacharathe Sarvaparapakshamapanathe Sarvamangalavapyarthe Mahamangala Nirajanam Sandarshayami Rakshandharayami Bhratsamakshabhradvidyavrushtiyam Drashabhota Shabhatam Ugravīram Indrastomena Panjadashena Madhyamitam Vatena Sagarena Raksha Rakshandharayami.
Devadevottama Devata Sarvabhuma Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Ashirvada Priya Ashirvadam Avadharaya. Om Swasti Prajabhya Paripalayantam Nyayena Margena Mahimahishah Go Brahmanebhya Subhamastu Nityam Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Kale Varshadu Varjanya Vritivi Sasya Shalini Desho Yamsho Varahitah Brahmana Santu Nirbhayah Iti Swasti Mantrartha Satya Sabala Bhavantu Iti Bhavanto Mahanto Nagrinhanto Tathastu Abutra Putrina Santu Putrina Santu Bautrinaha Adhana Sadhana Santu Jivanta Sura Darshatam Iti Bhavanto Mahanto Nagrinhanto Tathastu Durjana Sarjano Bhuyat Sarjana Shanti Mapnuyat Shanto Mucheta Vandebhya Muktas Chanjan Vimochayet Iti Bhavanto Mahanto Nagrinhanto Tathastu Raja Dharma Padihi Praja Sucharitaha Puja Dana Sajjanaha Shatkarma Prevarat Vijaha Pratidinam Vidya Anavadya Sadavani Sannihita Chiram Kavimukaihi Sanandam Avyakulaha Sarve Santu Vaidika Dharma Anushtataraha Saujanya Santoshinaha Iti Swasti Mantrartha Satya Saphalabhavanto Iti Bhavanto Mahanto Nagrinhanto Tathastu Esham Deva Devanam Mahadevanam Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayakanam Sakala Bhuvishristi Sthiti Sammarati Robhava Anugrahakya Panchakritya Varayananam Adimadhyam Tarahitanam Aprameya Parakramanam Tattvartha Gocharanam Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Swarupanam Shri Adiguru Arunagiri Yogishwara Swarupanam Shri Kala Bhairava Mahakali Swarupanam Shri Kailasonnata Dvajashanta Shyamala Peetharuda Shri Meenakshi Sundareshwara Vinna Swarupa Parashiva Putra Ratnakumara Guru Manya Tulya Avatara Shri Parvati Stanyapana Labdha Divya Jnana Vishruta Sakala Nigamagama Sarabhuta Dravida Veda Pravaktre Shri Mat Paramashiva Karuna Samadhigata Mukta Mayajudra Shreyana Giyamana Chatra Shamara Shri Chinhakaladi Samastavirada Valyalankrita Jnana Vijnana Chakravarti Sarvajana Sangha Sadyo Nirvana Dikshavya Yapavarka Varsha విశ్రానజీమూత పరమదకలపకేసరి శైవ సిద్ధాంత స్థాపనాచార్య శ్రీ రాజాదిరాజపాండ్య మహారాజగురు శవనశాఖ్యాది మహాంధకారనివారణ జ్ఞాన భాను వీక్షణా నరహర దుదోచ్ఛేదనమూర్వక శ్రీమద్ వృషభద్వజ స్థాపక శైవ సమయ కర్త్రే సర్వజ్ఞపీఠారూఢ శ్రీ జగద్గురు శ్రీ జ్ఞాన సంబంధ దేశిక స్వామి వాగీశు సుందర మాణిక్యవాచక స్వామినాం అవతారభూత శ్రీ జ్ఞాన సంబంధ స్వామి పునరుద్ధృత శ్యామలాపీఠ సర్వజ్ఞపీఠ త్రిణవత్యుత్తర ద్విశతమ గురు మహాసన్నిధానానాం అరుణగిరి యోగేశ్వర పరంపరాగత అరుణాచల సర్వజ్ఞపీఠ గురు మహాసన్నిధానానాం నిత్యోత్సవ నిత్యమంగ కైలాస పరంపరాగత కాంచీ కైలాస సర్వజ్ఞపీఠ త్రయస్త్రింశదుత్తర ద్విశతమ గురు మహాసన్నిధానానాం నిత్యోత్సవ నిత్యమంగళ నిత్య కళ్యాణ నిత్య రజత ఆది కైలాస నిత్యానందపీఠ మహాసంస్థాన మహాసింహాసన పీఠ కర్త్రేనాం సాక్షాత్ శ్రీ పరమశివ సముద్భూత కైలాస పరంపరాగత వైవస్వతమను ఇక్ష్వాకు హరిశ్చంద్ర భగీరథ శ్రీరామచన్న సూరసేన ఇత్యాద్యనవచ్ఛిన్న సార్వభౌమ చక్రవర్తి పరంపరాగత చతుషష్టి యోగిని మండిత చతుషష్టి సంప్రదాయ ప్రవర్తకమనుధర్మ శాసన సూర్యవంశ ప్రాప్త సర్వజ్ఞపీఠ సురాంగి సామ్రాజ్య మూర్ధాభిషిక్త చూడామణేన సాక్షాత్ శ్రీ పరమశివ సముద్భూత కైలాస పరంపరాగత శ్రీ కపిల మహాగురు పునరుద్ధృత మహానిర్వాణిపీఠ అష్టోత్తర సహస్ర శ్రీ మహామండలేశ్వరానాం సాక్షాత్ శ్రీ పరమశివ సముద్భూత శ్రీ మహాగణపతి సమారంభ అనవచ్ఛిన్న పీఠాధీశ్వర గురు పరంపరా ప్రాప్త అటలపీఠ అష్టోత్తర సహస్రతమ అష్టోత్తర సహస్ర శ్రీ అటల పీఠాధీశ్వరానాం ధర్మముక్తి స్వర్గపుర స్వర్ణపీఠ త్రయోవింశ గురు మహాసన్నిధానానాం కైలాస పరంపరా ఆదిపీఠ సర్వజ్ఞపీఠ జగద్గురూనాం శ్రీ కైలాస పునరుద్ధారకానాం శ్రీ కైలాస పరమాచార్యానాం శ్రీమద్ పరమహంసానాం పరివ్రాజకాచార్యవర్యానాం సచ్చిదానంద ప్రణవ స్వరూపానాం శ్రోత్రియ బ్రహ్మనిష్టానాం శ్రీమజ్జగద్గురూణాం శ్రీల శ్రీ భగవచ్చ్రీ నిత్యానంద పరమశివ శ్రీ జ్ఞాన సంబంధ దేశిక పరమాచార్య స్వామినాం పాదారవిందయోః భక్తి సిద్ధిః సమేషాం సహకుటుంబానాం సకలైశ్వర్య ప్రాప్తిః గురుకృపాకటాక్ష సిద్ధిః క్షేమస్థైర్య వీర్య విజయాయురారోగ్య ఐశ్వర్యానాం అభివృద్ధిః ఆరోగ్య దృఢగాత్రతా సిద్ధిః ఆచంద్రార్కవ వంశాభివృద్ధిః ధర్మార్థ కామ మోక్ష చతుర్విధ ఫలపురుషార్థ సిద్ధిః సర్వేషాం మనసా చింతిస సత్కార్యానుశూల సిద్ధిః సర్వదేవదేవీ స్వరూపస్య భగవచ్చ్రీ నిత్యానంద పరమశివస్య పాదారవిందయోః అచంచలా భక్తి సిద్ధిః భగవచ్చ్రీ నిత్యానంద పరమశివ ప్రసాదేన సకుటుంబస్య జ్ఞాన వైరాగ్య జీవన్ముక్తి ప్రాప్తిశ్చ భూయాత్ ఇతి భవంతో మహాంతో నగృహ్ణంతో తథాస్తు సర్వే జనా సుఖినః సంతు తథాస్తు సర్వేషాం శాంతిర్భవతు తథాస్తు సమస్త సన్మంగళాని సంతు తథాస్తు సర్వత్ర నిత్యానంద ధ్వజారోహణం భవతు తథాస్తు సర్వేషాం శ్రీల శ్రీ భగవచ్చ్రీ నిత్యానంద పరమశివ శ్రీ జ్ఞాన సంబంధ దేశిక పరమాచార్య స్వామినాం పరిపూర్ణ కృపాకటాక్ష సిద్ధిః అస్తు తథాస్తు అయం ధర్మ ఉత్తరోత్తరం అభివృద్ధిరస్తు తథాస్తు సర్వం భగవచ్చ్రీ నిత్యానంద పరమశివ పాదుకార్పణమస్తు ఓం నిత్యానందం మంగళం కల్పవృక్షాయ మంగళం జ్ఞానదాయినే సదాశివాయ శ్రీ నిత్యానందేశ్వరాయ మంగళం మంగళం శ్రీ మంగళం కామదాయిన్యే సర్వమంగళదాత్రే నిత్యానందేశ్వర్యే మంగళం మంగళం గురుదేవాయ మోక్షమూలాయ మంగళం పరావతార నిత్యానందాయ గురవే మంగళం ధ్యానమూలం గురోర్మూర్తి పూజామూలం గురోః పదం మంత్రమూలం గురోర్వాక్యం మోక్షమూలం గురోః కృపా. ఓం యత్కించిత్ కర్మ దేవేశ సదా సుకృదుష్కృతం తన్మే శివవదస్థస్య భుంక్షక్షపై శంకర శివోధాత శివోభోక్త శివసర్వమిదం జగద్ శివో యజతి సర్వత్ర యశివస్తోహమేవతు. ఓం పూర్ణమదః పూర్ణమిదం పూర్ణాత్ పూర్ణముదచ్యతే Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Tat Sat Sarvam Bhagavat Shri Nityananda Paramashiva Paduka Arpanamastu Om Nityanandam.
E. Kailasa is proper customized spiritual service helping you to identify your root patterns of suffering. We have perfected the science of helping every individual from every cultural, religious, nationality background. Have lowest reactionary assumptions, highest awakened response, alive response for life continuously. I want the whole world to know Hindus have something great to contribute to the world. We have something great to contribute to the world. Let us do that. If you are interested in enlightenment, we will immediately bring this to you. If you are not interested, we will explain the whole science, inspire you and make you interested in enlightenment science. We need to cater this enlightenment science to the whole world wherever they are, because enlightenment is the birthright of all human beings. Kailasa is responsible to provide that to all human beings.
Ready. You are going to experience literally Paramashiva. Most powerful, intangible but definitive, intense processes. This is the most powerful spiritual nuclear explosion that strong force of Kailasa landing on planet Earth directly. One thing I can be sure, you will not exist end of the program. I can guarantee that. Only Paramashiva will be there. Whatever you think as your strength, like how much cash you have, how much gold you have, how much money you have in the bank, what all properties you have, your secret passwords, passcodes, your strength secrets, you will tell only to your son or your daughter to whom you are going to give your inheritance. Same way, most important powerful secrets Paramashiva has given to his son Muruga, Subramanya, in Agama called Sarvanyanottaragama. All the powerful secrets the father will tell only to his son. It is too secret. I am going to open that Agama and give all the essence of all those secrets. Secrets of Charyapada lifestyle, secrets of Kriyapada, secrets of Yogapada and secrets of Jnanapada. I am not only going to teach you, I am going to give you exactly what Paramashiva gave it to Subramanya. Because Paramashiva himself is manifesting through this being now, giving you all exactly what was given to Subramanya. Nothing is required from your side. Just sit like innocent Subramanya, Muruga at the feet of Paramashiva. I assure you, whatever was given to Subramanya, the whole life will be given to you now. Not just words, teachings, not even just experience, life itself. I am talking to each one of you sitting in your room. I'll make you all Subramanya. Kailasa is the totality of the knowledge I received from my gurus and practice.
Bhakti is manifested in my life, perfected by teaching millions of people from all cultures, time zones, backgrounds, genders, nationality, race, from every creed. So this absolutely perfected knowledge available to you, served to you in your home without even you moving out of your couch, free of cost. Hinduism cannot live exclusively as one sampradaya. No. All sampradayas of Hinduism is an ecosystem. So don't keep quiet thinking that if one sampradaya is attacked, only that sampradaya is going to be affected. All of us are ecosystem. I invite all of you to get involved and enjoy Hinduism by the principle of Dharmo Rakshati Rakshitaha. When you protect Dharma, Dharma protects you. Even a malignous man, by beginning in the company of satsanga, makes even the impossible as possible in this world. E Kailasa is the message from Paramashiva to have super conscious breakthrough. Power manifestation, Paramashiva, everything served to you without you even moving out of your couch. We have perfected the science of helping every individual from every cultural, religious, nationality background. We can multiply the quality and quantity of your life. The most ancient, best way of life and best kept sacred secrets all these years, handed over only from guru to disciple, guru to disciple, guru to disciple. Secrets kept inside the Siddha Paramparas, Siddha tradition. Enlightenment is the birthright of all human beings. Kailasa is responsible to provide that to all human beings. Whole world should become e-Kailashya. E Kailasa is enlightenment ecosystem, literally enlightenment itself in your own home, wherever you are. Proper offer customized spiritual service helping you to complete with your life negativity, withdrawal from life, self-hatred, self-denial, self-doubt, so much of tiredness, laziness. We can support you aligning your diet, your attitude, your aptitude, your understanding about life. We can help you with everything. All of you, the whole world, to come and celebrate, enjoy not only the enlightenment ecosystem, the beauty of how it is getting revived. Be an insider for this great revival process. If you are an insider even for a startup company, you will understand not only the result of the company, even that being an insider is such a joy. Being an insider when it was happening is something extraordinary. So, I welcome all of you to come and be part of an insider of this revival of Kailasa, the enlightenment ecosystem, sovereign order of Kailasa, Kailasa nation itself. I request and welcome, invite all of you to become e-Kailashian. Get your free passport and make billions receive this free passport. Mean by the word e Kailasa? Listen intensely. Enlightenment ecosystem, literally enlightenment itself, in your own home, wherever you are. If you cannot come to Kailasa, it's okay. Kailasa can come to you. Kailasa coming to you is e Kailasa. E Kailasa is proper customized spiritual service helping you to identify your root patterns of suffering. We have perfected the science of helping every individual from every cultural, religious, nationality background. Will have lowest reactionary assumptions, highest awakened response, alive response for life continuously. I want the whole world to know Hindus have something great to contribute to the world.
we have something great to contribute to the world. Let us do that.
If you are interested in enlightenment, we will immediately bring this to you. If you are not interested, we will explain the whole science, inspire you, and make you interested in enlightenment science. We need to cater this enlightenment science to the whole world wherever they are, because enlightenment is the birthright of all human beings. Kailasa is responsible to provide that to all human beings. Ready. You are going to experience literally Paramashiva. Most powerful, intangible but definitive, intense processes. This is the most powerful spiritual nuclear explosion, that strong force of Kailasa landing on planet Earth directly. One thing I can be sure, you will not exist end of the program. I can guarantee that. Only Paramashiva will be there. Whatever you think as your strength, like how much cash you have, how much gold you have, how much money you have in the bank, what all properties you have, your secret passwords, passcodes, your strength secrets, you will tell only to your son or your daughter, to whom you are going to give your inheritance. Same way, most important powerful secrets Paramashiva has given to his son Muruga Subramanya in agama called Sarvanyanottaragama. All the powerful secrets the father will tell only to his son. It is too secret. I am going to open that agama and give all the essence of all those secrets. Secrets of Charyapada lifestyle, secrets of Kriyapada, secrets of Yogapada, secrets of Jnanapada. I am not only going to teach you, I am going to give you exactly what Paramashiva gave it to Subramanya. Because Paramashiva himself is manifesting through this being now, giving you all exactly what was given to Subramanya. Nothing is required from your side. Just sit like innocent Subramanya, Muruga at the feet of Paramashiva. I assure you, whatever was given to Subramanya, the whole life will be given to you now. Not just words, teachings, not even just experience, life itself. I am talking to each one of you sitting in your room. I'll make you all Subramanya. KAILASA is the totality of the knowledge I received from my gurus and practice manifested in my life, perfected by teaching millions of people from all cultures, time zones, backgrounds, genders, nationality, race, from every creed. So this absolutely perfected knowledge available to you, served to you in your home without even you moving out of your couch, free of cost. Hinduism cannot live exclusively as one sampradaya. No. All sampradayas of Hinduism is an ecosystem. So don't keep quiet thinking that if one sampradaya is attacked, only that sampradaya is going to be affected. All of us are ecosystem. I invite all of you to get involved and enjoy Hinduism by the principle of Dharmo Rakshati Rakshitaha. When you protect Dharma, Dharma protects you. Even a malignous man, by beginning in the company of satsangha, makes even the impossible as possible in this world. E Kailasa is the message from Paramashiva to have super conscious breakthrough. Power manifestation, Paramashiva, everything served to you without you even moving out of your couch. we have perfected the science of helping every individual from every cultural, religious, nationality background. We can multiply the quality and quantity of your life. The most ancient, best way of life and best kept sacred secrets all these years, handed over only from guru to disciple, guru to disciple, guru to disciple. Secrets kept inside the Siddha Paramparas, Siddha tradition. Enlightenment is the birthright of all human beings. Kailasa is responsible to provide that to all human beings. Whole world should become e-Kailashians. E-Kailasa is enlightenment ecosystem, literally enlightenment itself in your own home, wherever you are. Proper customized spiritual service helping you to complete with your life negativity, withdrawal from life, self-hatred, self-denial, self-doubt, so much of tiredness, laziness. We can support you aligning your diet, your attitude, your aptitude, your understanding about life. We can help you with everything. All of you, the whole world, to come and celebrate, enjoy not only the enlightenment ecosystem, the beauty of how it is getting revived. Be an insider for this great revival process. If you are an insider, even for a startup company, you will understand not only the result of the company, even that being an insider is such a joy. Being an insider when it was happening is something extraordinary. So, I welcome all of you to come and be part of an insider of this revival of Kailasa, the enlightenment ecosystem, sovereign order of Kailasa, Kailasa nation itself. I request and welcome, invite all of you to become e-Kailashian. Get your PE passport and make billions receive this PE passport.
What is an Adinam? An Adinam is the name of a traditional Shaivite commune where the Guru resides and facilitates Sadashivatva to his disciples. Here, in the Bengaluru Adinam, His Holiness the Avatar Paramahamsa Nithyananda, Sadashiva himself, entangles us all in Shaktinipada. Shaktinipada is the celebration of oneness, oneness with Sadashiva, oneness with the whole cosmos itself. What does the Guru do? Nainisharanya, Takshasila, Nalanda, Sharada Peetam, Haridwar, Kashi Vishwad Peetam. These are the names of traditional universities built off the sacred Agamic revelations of Sadashiva, the Vedas and the Agamas. His Holiness the Avatar Paramahamsa Nithyananda's vision is to revive these lost universities and their great contributions to this planet's knowledge and power. His calling for a Vedic Renaissance has the Nithyananda University at its heart. Swamiji's great vision through this university is to create an enlightened community with new enlightened civilizations across the planet. Swamiji, through his universities around the planet Earth, is serving humanity by reviving the Ved Agamic tradition, bringing immense prosperity, physical and mental health, and the way of life as per Sanatana Hindu Dharma. When you become an Adinavasi under the Nithyananda University, the wealth of the whole Sanatana Hindu Dharma is at your consumption.
Nithyananda Publications, rejoicing the words of the Avatar and delivering them in every possible way.
Nithyananda Yoga is to express the space, state, powers and cognition of Sadashivoham.
Nithyananda Vision, capturing Swamiji's teachings and broadcasting it to the world.
Sarvajni.
Become an all-knower and enrich the world with Vedagamic wisdom of Sadashiva.
Green Adina, recovering the most resourceful and self-sustaining knowledge from the ancient world, making Mother Earth green again.
Nithyananda Construction.
Discover the architectural genius of our ancestors and build a temple for Sadashiva.
KAILASA is proper customized spiritual service helping you to identify your root patterns of suffering. We have perfected the science of helping every individual from every cultural, religious, nationality background. Have lowest reactionary assumptions, highest awakened response, alive response for life continuous.
Kevalam jnanamottim Dvandvaditam gagana sadrisham tattvamasyadilaksham ekam nityam vimalamachalam sarvadhi sakshibhutam bhavaditam trigunarhitam sadguram tam namami. Nithyananda, welcome each and every one of you joining us here today on Nithyananda TV, Kailasa's
official TV channel. Swamiji, His Divine Holiness, Jagatguru Mahasannidhanam, Supreme Pontiff of Hinduism, has taken the enormous effort and is reviving the only Hindu nation, Sri Kailasa. As a part of that revival, to revive ancient Dharma, to revive the Vedic tradition, and to give legitimate space where all these religions can live and practice in peace, in harmony, Swamiji has taken and is performing this enormous effort for the sake of Hindus, so that Hindus can live Hinduism. As a part of this, Swamiji has introduced the Vakyata Satas and Jivahata Satas to all of us. Every day, Swamiji gives the Nitya Satsang through his various teachings, discourses, even all the books he's written. So many different ways, more than hundreds and thousands of hours, Swamiji has given so much of teachings for all of us, so much of powerful cognitions and powerful thought currents. But just listening to those words, those teachings from Swamiji is only like eating the food. Unless the food is digested, it has no real meaning for the body. The same way, even after listening to the truths from the master, unless the Vakyata Satas happens, unless the churning and the essence of it is absorbed by the body, only then it has true meaning. Swamiji beautifully says that for imbibing any truth, there are four steps. The first, listening to the truth from the master, is the first 25%. The second 25% happens when you internalize and do the manana. The third 25% happens when you have the Vakyata Satas, when you discuss these truths with others and have the vada prativada, the debate. And the last 25% happens when you do the Jivartha Satas, when you live these truths in your life. Now, let's watch a small clip where Swamiji, he himself, speaks about the importance of Vakyata Satas and why Vakyata Satas is necessary. Please stay tuned.
Listen, listen. Manana, Vakyartha Sadas every day will give you a complete understanding. Not only that, please listen, every time when you keep these spiritual truths in your inner space, analyze them, think about them, contemplate on them, every moment you spend on intra-analyzing these great truths, your incompletions melt down. You are living Advaita. Understand, how much ever you struggle to find the solution externally, you will never find. You will never find the solution what you expect externally. If you think, I'll finish all the work, I took it on myself or Swamiji gave it to me, and then I'll rest in peace. Never. Even after you leave the body, we have work for you. Understand, if you are expecting, the external solution, no. You need to be told you are a fool. Wherever you really need to be told you are a fool, you should be told that is the real good thing for you. Only then you will understand the seriousness and start taking medication. Manana, intranalyzing, is really, really, really important. Because the life gets aligned to living Advaita with Manana. Shankara says beautifully, Shruti Shatagunam Vidyan Mananam Mananat Abhinitidhyasanam Lakshagunam Anantam Nirvigalpam. The meaning is manana is 100 times superior to shravana. Intranalyzing is 100 times superior to listening. And living is 100 times superior to intranalyzing. Nirvikalpa samadhi, living advaita, is infinitely superior. Please understand, you need to listen and internalize again and again and again. That is why I am insisting on Vakyartha Sadas. Even if there are 2-3 sannyasis in your ashram, start the Vakyartha Sadas. Slowly devotees will start gathering. Everywhere, in every ashram, every center, just like puja is compulsory, Vakyartha Satas should become compulsory. More and more learning, more and more internalizing, more and more completion. Understand, other than the spiritual solution, there is no solution. How much ever you try to find any solution, any problem, whether it is personal, professional, organizational, intrapersonal, and interpersonal. Interpersonal is direct fight. Intrapersonal is cold war. You won't fight, but you will be waiting. See, it's like directly when you fight, it becomes like equal fight. But I have seen many cunning fellows, they won't directly fight. They will wait. At some point, they will get that neutral person position. That time, they will use that position and attack. When somebody else is attacking him, when he is fighting with somebody else, he is a neutral person. Now, come on, use that. An attack. Violence. How much ever you hide, how much ever you keep inside, and how much ever cunningly you plan, finally it is going to stink inside you, not anybody else. Whether it is interpersonal problem, intrapersonal problem, organizational problem, professional problem, or personal problem, the only way anything can be solved is spiritual solution. Vakyartha Sadas is the best way for a spiritual solution. discovering spiritual solution for any problem.
Chandan, we're back. So beautifully Swamiji explained the importance of the Vakyasadas, why it is necessary to have the Vakyasadas every day. I don't know how many of you had joined with us previously yesterday, but Ashutosha Maharaj had beautifully shared yesterday his life experience and how he came and met Swamiji. He had shared that even though after changing his whole external environment, he still after 2 years felt the same boredom and felt the same without a purpose in life. So Swamiji beautifully addresses those problems in this satsang, where he says, no matter how much of the external situations you try to change, nothing will change because the problem resides inside. You can never find an external source, you can never find external solution for your internal problem. So, without further ado, let me go ahead and introduce the rest of the panel joining us here today for the Vakyata Satas. My name is Sri Nitya Mangalananda, and I'm a Balasanth of Nithyananda Gurukul. I joined the Nithyananda Gurukul back in 2012 and have been here ever since. Along with me, I have Sri Nitya Rajananda sitting here as well, live from Adi Kailasa Bhardi. Around the world, we have many people joining us today. We have Sanjay Ji joining us from London. We also have Ashutosh Ananda and Jnanatmananda, both of them joining us from Canada. We have Murli Ayya joining us from Chennai. And we have Sri Nitya Achyutamayananda joining us also today, newly. Thank you all so much for joining us here today. So I'm going to just go ahead and let everyone introduce themselves, starting with the Raja Maharaj, for all our viewers watching us today. Yes, Maharaj.
Nithyanandam. My name is Sri Nitya Rajananda, and I am also a Balasanth of the Nithyananda Gurukul. And been trained by Swamiji with the temple and the puja, and got to know a lot of the beautiful things that I learned was especially how Swamiji does his puja. And he always says, you should see my puja. And I had an opportunity to see that almost every day whenever he comes to temple and sits or stands before the deities and offers his prayers. It's one of the most beautiful things to see and cherish. And I'm grateful to Swamiji to have given this opportunity to me. And with that knowledge and deep devotion that we learned from seeing Swamiji, we reproduce that in everyone and teach people how to do puja and how to have temple. So that's a little bit about me and the work I do. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Maharaj. So go ahead and let Sanjay Ji introduce himself. You can go ahead, Aya. Thank you so much, Aya, for joining us today. Next, we have Ashutosh Ananda from Canada. You can go ahead.
those things which you don't necessarily get you get to know when you before engaging into the spiritual path. But on the spiritual path, there's a lot of things which are unexplainable but happened and are very much real. And so during this experience, Ashtosha was so, a lot of like the self-doubt and everything just vanished instantly, and tears of bliss started to roll out, and it was an intense experience. And then and like that, other experiences happened as well. And then after that, I did apply for the sannyas training, and Swamiji initiated me into Krama Brahmacharya, the lifestyle. And since then, I've been in the Sangha and expanding the cognitions about what Swamiji is constantly sharing with all of us. So very happy to be here today for this Vrakatasaras. Nityananda.
Thank you so much for joining us here today. Next, we have Nyanatmananda, also joining us from Canada. Go ahead.
Nityananda Maharaj, thank you so much. Nityananda, everyone. My name is Sri Nityananda. I'm an elementary school teacher and computer engineering technologist from Canada. I've worked in more than 30 schools with more than 100 teachers around the world in education, taught yoga meditation for the last 20 years, and found out about Swamiji in 2008. And since then, have spent about 10 or 11 years sort of full-time on this path, and was blessed to be initiated into the path of Brahmacharya by Swamiji in 2015. And thank you to Swamiji and for everyone else for being here. Thank you, Nityananda.
Thank you so much for joining us here today. Next, we have Murli Ayya joining us from Chennai. You can go ahead, Ayya, and introduce yourself.
Thank you, Maharaj. This is Murli from Chennai. I'm a teacher and a trainer by profile. And I connected with Swamiji from way back since 2013. I should say, like, I was totally directionless in my life. Nothing whatever I was I tried was clicking. Nothing ever turned out to be successful. I didn't know, understand where I was lacking, what I was lacking, where I was missing something. And it was through very hard and tough journey, I realized that it is the spiritual strength that one calls. I understood that for one to be successful, one needs physical strength, mental strength, emotional strength, and spiritual strength. So among this, I think it is the spiritual strength that was most lacking. Whatever I did have, I understood that it was the spiritual strength that was most missing. And I had to pay a very heavy price before I realized this. And after coming to Swamiji, I began to see sense in many things. I began to understand the purpose of many things, and I had dropped out of many things. See, during my inner Nekun program, Swamiji asked us to keep away from mobile phones. And I was wondering, how can I ever keep away my mobile phone? Not that I was addicted to it. At that time, the smartphone was not even there. So it was not, I was addicted to it, but physically parting away from it was too much for me. But when I came to the inner program, I realized, did I even have it? Did I even need it? So such a huge transformation it was. That one change itself made me realize a lot of little things. And I'll share all that during the course of the discussion happening here. Thank you for the mic time. Back to Maharaj.
Thank you so much, Ayya, for joining us here today. So we have Achyutananda joining us newly. Achyutamayananda joining us newly today. Yes, you can go ahead and introduce yourself.
Yes, Nityananda, thank you very much. Thank you very much, everybody. My name is Srinityananda Achyutamayananda, and I'm from San Antonio, Texas in the U.S. And I came to reach Swamiji during an inner awakening in 2017. And this brought a major, major transformation in my life, a rather quick transformation. Before inner awakening, I was in the accounting background. I was starting off my career in that field. And since then, there was just a huge transformation in coming into Hinduism, meeting the master, My life made several big changes. I was living in the Adinam for about 2 years in India with Swamiji. And then since then, I've been living mainly in the temple, doing full-time seva in the Houston temple. And since then, now I'm here back in San Antonio, Texas. And yes, Nithyanandam.
Nithyanandam, thank you so much for joining us here today. And last but not least, we also have Ranoshan joining us from Canada. We can go ahead, Ranoshan, and introduce yourself for all of us.
Thank you. Nithyanandam. My name is Ranoshan and I'm from Toronto, Canada. I have a degree in software engineering and I also studied medicine a little bit. And I got to know Swamiji around 2013. Actually, one thing I just wanted to share is actually life before Swamiji and life after Swamiji. Just one quick point is life before Swamiji, even just looking back now, is the way I'll relate with life anytime some up or down happens ends up actually being a kind of silly conversation with life. It becomes like the tools we think we have for life are not actually tools, but just simply a silly conversation. But then after Swamiji, after literally being blessed with Swamiji in the life, then the whole relationship with life becomes mature. The whole relationship with life, it's like Swamiji gives you enough powerful cognition. Swamiji gives you enough power. Swamiji gives you enough feeling connection. Swamiji gives you, I won't even use the word enough, but Swamiji gives you surplus. Swamiji gives you abundance. Swamiji gives you everything, anything you want. Swamiji gives you more than enough. Literally abundance. And really the conversation with life becomes mature conversations. And the life solutions you have are totally different. And it's one thing that is really, really a huge thing, especially now with the post-COVID world where there's a lot of global issues and everything. Even these simple life solutions attend to so many situations. And it's really something I feel that after being with Swamiji, it really is such a blessing and a responsibility, actually. So yes, this is just my introduction. Nithyanandam.
Nithyanandam, so much. Thank you so much for joining us here today. So just to brief everyone and all the viewers who are watching the Vakya Sathas today, since December 14th, the Vakya Sathas, we have been discussing immensely about how the pralaya has affected all our lives. And Swamiji again and again had repeatedly said in the satsangs after the ending of pralaya, where the pralaya, even though it is officially over, it has gone and has settled inside all of us as in the forms of various thoughts, various decisions which we had made. And Swamiji told that it is important now that before we continue and go on with our life, before we now resume from where we had left off before the COVID-19 had set in, Swamiji wanted us, all of us, to sit and iron out ourselves, pick out those identities, those thought currents, those decisions which we had taken up during pralaya, as all of them are tainted with the pralaya. And only once we completely iron and filter our inner space, clean our inner space from these decisions, these thought currents, only then we'll truly come out of pralaya. Only then for us pralaya will truly end. Over the course of the past 2-3 days, Vakya Sathas, we had discussed how we can identify those thought currents and those decisions which we had taken during the pralaya, the ones which we are supposed to discard and renounce. Yesterday we had discussed about how Swamiji himself had given one of the best ways to fully come out of the effect of pralaya is to see yourself as Paramashiva and to see everyone around you as well as Paramashiva. And in the course of the discussion, we had come to the conclusion where power manifestation is one of the best ways to cognize yourself and others and everything else as Paramashiva. Today, in the Vakya Sathas, we're going to bring up a very important topic, a very important aspect of the pralaya. How the pralaya affected us in terms of our relationship with the Guru. How without even our knowledge, we had been moved away from the Guru, and how that is affecting us. What can we do right now to bring us back to the space of the Guru? Bring us back into integrity with Him, into oneness with Him. It can be the smallest thing, from sleeping during his satsang to as big as announcing and saying that I'll not be a part of this anymore. Both of these are just different frequencies and different variations of the same thing, where due to some other misunderstanding, some other cognition which isn't complete, whatever incompletions or half-baked ideas, all these things lead to slowly moving away from the master. So today's topic, today's question is, how do we identify those thought currents, those ideas which are pulling us away from the master? How do we complete them, and how do we bring ourselves more and more in oneness, more and more in integrity with the Guru? So this is the question placed before us today. I'm going to hand over the mic to Rajananda Maharaj and ask him to share his powerful cognitions and thought currents.
Thank you, Maharaj. I wanted to add is the question that you're asking. We all know where we have may have stepped away or may have been not integrated with the Guruvak or the way that the Swamiji wants us to guide, is guiding us. We know that very clearly, and maybe many people may be oblivious to it or not knowing to it until somebody has pointed it out. But it is understanding it fully that how much it has moved us away from him. Any thought or any small decision, thinking that something is not practical, something is not I'm not able to do, something is very difficult to do. In these times, when these things come up, what is a guru other than the, what is Swamiji other than the life intensified, life in front of you intensified? So whatever it comes, you only point your finger back towards him and saying, no, what you have not given me the correct cognition to handle this. You have not given me the way to understand this. Where you will blame and you will point the finger, but you should also understand at least that the solution is being given by him only. And what I wanted to add to what we are asking is that how far have we gone away? For what I remember, how one should celebrate the Guru and have the Guru in their life. Guru Gita gives tremendous amount of examples of how one should cherish the Guru in their life. I mean, every day in Uttama Uttama Seva, we chant Dhyana Moolam Guru or Murti, Puja Moolam Guru of Padam, Mantra Moolam Guru or Vakyam, Moksha Moolam Guru of Krupa. Meaning that the root, the source of all meditation and all visualization is the Guru's form. The source of all mantra is the words of the Guru. The source of all ritual, puja, worship is the feet of the Guru. And the source of all liberation is the grace of the Guru. So this is what we chant and every day. So I was thinking about this past few days and how Swamiji has been guiding us in the satsang and through the Vakyartha service also, and through the daily events, how first he talked about the pralay and what all is become redundant because of it. Next he asked us to look into what all thought currents we had picked up from pralay that we should not make any decisions on. And now he has beautifully given last night the first principle of Paramashiva there, that is that it is original truth that we are Paramashiva. It is not something we need to go for towards and go and achieve, but it is the original reality that is that we are Paramashiva. So he is guiding us and moving us forward, and I'm having an internal going through the internal looking back as Swamiji is asking us and seeing how in the last year how many decisions I have made have caused a lot of damage, with which if I act on those now or continue to act, the rejuvenation won't be complete. The pralaya is a time for the rejuvenation. So if I take those same damaging thoughts and act on them now, I will be acting on them and pralaya will still be instilled inside me. So me, I am finding out that yesterday I had brought out the point of where I was negligent, where I did not do something that I should have done or could have done, or I did not even think about doing an action where I have to correct something, where I have to become more authentic in something, or where I have to add, either because I didn't believe I would be able to, or I didn't believe that person has any listening for me. So this is where I practically felt where I missed, this pralaya has settled in me in this way, where I have become inauthentic. But one more thing that I realized is, I felt a little overwhelmed yesterday, that maybe it's a lot actually that I'm missing. How do I get back? And similarly, how do I come back to a space where I feel I'm powerful and I can go look forward to a future, rather than now I'm seeing I have this much things I have to deal with. I have this much irritations, this much frustrations, this much anger. When how do I renounce these and go forward? And I had a click at that time, a powerful cognition, if you can say, that if I don't know, literally, I just had to surrender it. I thought only I can pray, Swamiji, help me come out of this. Swamiji, help me relieve myself. I can still see that I have this much anger and this much of the issues inside me. This my reactionary based assumptions. And I don't know if I know you to guide it. Your guidance is, even your guidance, even seeking his guidance wasn't the thing. Because in satsang, if you sincerely seek guidance from Swamiji, in satsang he gives you the answer. Many of us know that. Many of us know when we seek and sit and just pray that I need an answer to this question, it's answered in the satsang. But I didn't even have that. I only thought that I'll just pray, Swamiji, help me to come out of this. I didn't even think I'll be able to. So this is one of the things that Swamiji had told us, that if you're able to have powerful cognitions about yourself, have them. When you're not in that space, at least pray for them. So at least pray to have powerful cognitions. Let me, please give me, I'm open to it. So in that space, at least you will be more open and not closed. And that's what I'm realizing, where I've missed and in where I've missed and where I can correct myself. And so when it comes to missing the guru, this is the examples of where I do it, where I miss in getting lost in the impossibilities of things and not reassuring myself again and again that Swamiji is initiated and ordained. When he ordains, he sustains, and these kind of powerful cognitions. So it is in these moments only I realize I have to support myself, and this is the moments where I have, when I go beyond impossibilities, that is where I've missed the guru. That's what I wanted to share. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Maharaj. So I just wanted to just add one thing here. And it started off that you had mentioned that it's not something that we don't know. We already know where we are missing the guru. In most places, even if we don't know, when others pointed out to us as well, we know the actions from which we are doing. Like, for example, if a certain guruvak has been given, let's take morning puja. Swamiji has asked us to do morning puja every day, and not in alignment with that, some days we skip doing the puja. So yes, we know that we are not in alignment with the guruvak, that we are not doing puja every day. But half the time we do not know why we don't follow. Exactly what's the thought current behind us which we are taking that decision not to follow guruvak. Most of the times that is ignorant to all of us. And it is at that time that because we don't even want to identify the problem with which we are not following guruvak is the base root cause of many of these problems. Because it will be the same thought current which is missing guruvak, and the same thought current why we are not doing puja, the same thought current which reflects somewhere else in a bigger issue, which people might think that issues which actually matter, like when Swamiji gives a real instruction or he gives some other work to do. Swamiji beautifully said that in Hinduism, we have multi-dimensional logic. For solving your relationship problems outside, all you need to do is cleanse your stomach. It's a very beautiful principle of how the whole Brahmanda resides in a single Pindanda, where even though the size is reduced, the quality and everything else is still the same. Excuse me. When you realize and understand that the problems, if we solve in the Pindanda, the problems will also be solved in the Brahmanda. A beautiful story in where Vishwamitra, he gives Trishanku, and Trishanku wants to go to Devaloka. And when Vishwamitra tries to send Trishanku to Devaloka, Indra casts him out of Devaloka. So he's trying to be pushed up by Vishwamitra, and he's being pushed down by Indra. So then Vishwamitra says, why Indra Loka, I'll give you a separate whole universe for yourself. And through his power of his bioenergy, he creates a completely new universe for Trishanku. And Trishanku is still residing there in that universe, created by Vishwamitra all those thousands of years ago. And this is the power of changing... excuse me. So this is one example of how Vishwamitra, just through his very will and bioenergy, created a whole universe for a single person. It is the same way when we apply this logic everywhere else. When we correct the small things in our life, doing puja every day, applying the vibhuti, Swamiji has given from small things which we should implement in our lifestyle to big cognitions which we should be carrying out with us throughout the day. At some point in some problem of our life, we might think, oh, what is all this powerful cognitions, all this only for speaking and debating, it's nothing in a practical, useful in a practical life. We feel that way because in another sense, it is basically the same cognition. If you have about in puja and vibhuti, the same thought kind of you have, what is the use of doing morning puja? It's just 4 or 5 minutes. How is this going to help me in my day-to-day life? All use of applying vibhuti, it's just a simple powder. How is this going to help me in my life? The same cognition which we are using to avoid the daily puja and the morning vibhuti, it is the same cognition which reflects in not implementing Swamiji's spiritual principles, his teachings in our day-to-day life. Finally, in the end, is the thought current. It will not be more than one or two thought currents. But those one or two thought currents are what is preventing us from identifying and solving many of the problems which we are facing in our life. Be it from morning puja till solving relationship with your spouse. Both of them reside in the same thought current, why we choose not to apply Swamiji's teachings in our life. So that's just all I wanted to share here. Go ahead and allow Sanjay ji to share his cognitions and thought currents on this. You can go ahead, Aya.
Actually, Nithyananda, I'm still forming my my cognitions on this topic. So,
oh, that's fine, Aya. So we can come back to you. Then maybe we can move on to Ashutosh Ananda and allow let him go ahead and share his thoughts. Please go ahead.
Yes, Nithyananda. One thing that Swamiji was sharing is that when Swamiji was introducing the four images, one of the clicks which Ashutosh had was Swamiji shared that the guru becomes the central point which allows you to reintegrate yourself with your with all your images, and that all the life image that we have and that we project everywhere, and that gets reflected to us in various ways, then that life image gets projected on the guru and it comes back to you. And when it comes back to you, you can do completion and come back to a space of pure life positivity. So one of the main clicks during this pralaya that Ashutosha had was in that space of, I know how it should be done. This is not how it should be done. It should be done like this. It should be done like that. This kind of inner space where you go into this mode of dictating how things are supposed to happen and how things are supposed to function, that inner space cuts your relationship with Guru. Because the purpose of the Guru-disciple relationship is for you to surrender. The Ramana Maharshi, Swamiji was quoting Ramana Maharshi, and the Ramana Maharshi was saying that the energy which is running the entire cosmos, don't you think that energy can run your life? But we fail to realize that. We fail to realize that energy is there, and you can surrender to it and it will take care of you 100%. But instead, we go into a mode where it's like, no, I know how it should be done. It should be done like this. It should be done like that. And when things are not going the way we want, we start to generate and cherish anger, frustration, restlessness, and all kinds of life negative emotions. So the main click was, no matter what is in front of you, no matter what is the Guru Vak, no matter how big a task is in front of you, it's jumping in it wholeheartedly And if at any point throughout there is any form of powerlessness, just being aware that there is powerlessness, surrendering it at Swamiji and asking Swamiji to guide and asking Swamiji's blessings for the continuation of the happening. And not start to decide, no, this is not how it should be done. It should be done like this. And not try to create your own, carve your own path, which is completely unnecessary. So that was one of the clicks. This attitude of wanting to do things your way and that your way is the right way, that thought current, it damages and destroys the feeling connection between the disciple and the guru.
Thank you so much for sharing your... Excuse me. Thank you so much, Ashutosha Maharaj, for sharing your... your powerful cognitions. Like to go ahead and allow Jnanatmananda to go ahead and share his thoughts. You can go ahead, yeah.
Nithyanandam, yeah, it's awesome to hear all these things. And with all the satsang Swamiji is giving is incredible. And continuing in the Vakada Saras and Swamiji saying, expanding towards living Advaita as it being infinitely more powerful. So just any kind of way, missing integrity at all. And so one of the things is just missing the opportunity that, and actually even how Swamiji is sharing that there's this opportunity actually to direct your excitement towards Swamiji. So sort of missing that part and missing that opportunity. So whatever it is, losing sight of the opportunity to engage with Swamiji or report with Swamiji and be involved in whatever kind of projects and opportunities. So just that opportunity to really sit with yourself and declare integrity from me to Swamiji, declare that I'm in integrity from now, make myself also to be sensitive to it and authentically integrated between me and Swamiji, and give the self some time also morning and night to reevaluate authenticity and integrity and redeclare the integrity anytime, and just working to make the self authentic and keeping myself looking at Swamiji and keeping this integrity with him, this focus on for me to him, a personal relationship. And so that opportunity to engage with Swamiji with excitement. So that is sort of even Mangala Maharaj telling about the Tyaga opportunity with avoiding to dump the food inside. So those kind of completions and so relieving of the fears by allowing those sort of things to happen. And just, being authentic with myself and my integrity, then how much excitement and integrity I can direct towards Swamiji, keeping that relationship there, keeping an eye on it every day. Swamiji really supports all of this, having the courage to look at him and declare integrity and be as authentic as possible with it, continue to stand. So there's an opportunity to direct excitement towards him. So it's a rare opportunity, and just wanting to declare these vows and to have that, to be engaged in that personal relationship with him, because we all have a personal relationship with him. Often we get distracted in other things, but actually he's engaged in a direct personal relationship with all of us. So that's mostly the thing, is Swamiji is always supporting us in integrity. So standing and declaring my integrity to him and focused on maintaining that to him. And he's saying, be more and more excited. That's the thing that exists when this body goes away, is your excitement. So that's what he is. So if you direct that towards him, he'll give it back to you 1,000 times. So that is sort of, that's the, from here, that's the perspective of how it's to move forward and maintain the integrity and completion.
Thank you so much, Shaya. Actually, there's a very beautiful point up which Jnanatmananda had brought up. each of us cherish a personal relationship with Swamiji. And if you go back a couple of months, Swamiji had given a beautiful technique on how we can, when you want to achieve Paramashiva, first think that you are Paramashiva and others are Paramashiva, first you need to experience what is Paramashiva for you. And many of us, we don't have any idea about Paramashiva. Other than Swamiji using the word again and again in Satsang, in our own imagination about him, in our real life sense, we don't have an idea of Paramashiva. But we do have an idea of Swamiji. We do have the relationships, the moments which you cherish the most with him. Those memories, those are actually the real moments of Paramashiva which are important to us. So again and again, remembering those moments, again and again, speaking to that Swamiji living inside of us, having that relationship with him, only when we start experiencing Paramashiva in that sense, because that is the only way in which we can experience Paramashiva, through Nitya Puja, through just talking to him inside ourselves. It is through these ways when we start experiencing really what is Paramashiva, he is powerful enough to change us and make him also like him, and then we'll be able to see others also as Paramashiva. So, Swamiji gave a beautiful technique where just whatever happens, whatever is going on in your life, whatever is going on in your day-to-day routine, just talk to that Paramashiva living inside you. Paramashiva, I got up now. I will go take bath. We need to go and continue the next routine. Just having the continuous conversation with Paramashiva inside of you, because he is the one waiting, when will you come and open up to him. So having that conversation with him, opening up to Swamiji, to that Paramashiva living inside of you, that is where the real Paramashiva, that is where really you actually start experiencing Paramashiva in your life. So just a small thing I wanted to add to Nyanatmananda. So I'm going to go ahead and allow Achyuta Mayananda to go and share his thoughts. You can go ahead now, yeah.
Yes, Nityanandam, thank you very much. Yeah, so a powerful cognition that actually came mainly from today's satsang, where Swamiji shared how we should, we need to realize ourselves as super consciousness and identify ourselves as, our first principle from where we operate from should be that super consciousness. And this super consciousness, it gives us a real confidence to manifest just anything. And anything that our objective reality, like our present circumstance is telling us, if we just realize that we are far beyond anything that is happening in the present moment in actuality, but in reality, we are this super consciousness. So whatever we manifest in our inner space will be manifested in the outer space. When we carry this principle of super consciousness, when we carry this principle as our first principle. And so, yes, relating with Swamiji through this realization of super consciousness allows us to identify ourselves with this super consciousness, because we go beyond ourselves, we go beyond our addictions or fears, powerlessness. If ever food or sleep is getting the best of you, if we just come back to our super consciousness, we could say, what do I really want to experience now? Or what would Paramashiva experience now if I could go beyond this food and this sleep and just about all my powerlessness? What is it truly inside that wants to be manifested? And when we use that super consciousness to manifest it, we can truly manifest just about anything, and anything we choose to be integrated to, we can manifest that. So yes, just wanted to bring back to that realization of ourselves as super consciousness.
Thank you so much. Nithyananda, thank you so much for sharing your powerful cognitions and your thought currents. So, now we'd like to hear from Ranoshan, like to hear his powerful cognitions and thought currents. You can go ahead, Ranoshan.
Nithyananda. Yeah, so actually, one really strong click that's happening is actually this space of laziness, tiredness, and boredom. And I'm really seeing that a lot of the time, especially when the relationship with Swamiji, these three are creates, if there's any gap, these threes are basically the root cause of the gap. Whether it's doing basically, whether it's contributing to Kailasa or basically remembering the powerful cognitions, practicing the powerful cognitions, doing the daily routines, all these things, the only real obstacle is the laziness, tiredness, and boredom. Entertaining the laziness, tiredness, and boredom. Like even things like practicing cognition, knowing Swamiji sharing this powerful cognition, either on live satsang or a live satsang, or even just casually watching a satsang and really having a strong click saying, okay, no, this is a really strong click. I should practice this and have the experience. And then sometime through the day, having some sort of laziness and saying, oh no, it's okay. Just this thing of, it's okay. This thing of invoking the laziness and saying, it's okay to the laziness, cherishing this laziness, cherishing this tiredness and boredom and this kind of thing. Really, I'm seeing, especially after the whole pralaya, this thing is actually bigger than it looks. It's a lot bigger than it looks. See, even on the level of super consciousness, as Achyutyamaya was sharing, the experience of super consciousness is always being excited about life. Being bored about life, being lazy with life, being tired with life is not super consciousness. It's compromising on the experience of super consciousness, actually. And really, Ranoshan's cognizing now, it's maybe a little bit of a strong word to say, but actually experiencing the laziness, tiredness, boredom, Ranoshan feels is actually compromising satya. Swamiji sharing the satya is you are super consciousness. And then cognizing this, cognizing the satya to, because it is satya for the sake of satya. Satya is the only thing that's actually true. And really, Ranoshan seeing, it's like, especially now as Ranoshan is sharing too, it's actually such a strong thing, is whenever we experience any one of these three, this tiredness, laziness, boredom, it is really a compromise on satya, because satya is the experience of super consciousness. It's not just personal experience, but it's the experience, as saying, as in the experience of super consciousness is the experience of personal experience and the experience of life itself. And so this is not, I feel, Ranoshan saying, like, this is the biggest gap that Ranoshan is having, especially in the day-to-day things, this thing of entertaining the laziness, tiredness, boredom, even manifesting powers. Sometimes after a certain point, this thing of boredom may happen. And especially this blessed space of being with Swamiji, Swamiji makes sure you don't give up. Swamiji makes sure you manifest the power. This is different. But if Ranoshan is practicing by himself somewhere, after a certain amount of time, maybe 20, 30 minutes, maybe 1-2 hours, then Ranoshan will feel bored with the power and then move on to something else. At least in Swamiji's space, Swamiji makes sure that this doesn't happen. Swamiji makes sure you manifest the power, even if it takes a number of hours. But he makes sure you manifest. But Ranoshan feels that entertaining this boredom is actually such a gap. And especially during this pralaya, it's really being put in front of you, seeing how big the gap is and how much it's actually we have to rejuvenate. Really, this rejuvenation has to happen. Refreshing the space has to happen. Refreshing the space in the space where actually, as Ranoshan is sharing, this one click is happening where Swamiji in one satsang is sharing, don't plan on conquering laziness for your whole life. Start with today. Just for today, for this day, conquer your laziness. Do the micromanagement. Live in an organized way. Become active in life. Really micromanage your inner space and outer space. Micromanage the whole thing. Really live in an organized way. Because when you're living in this organized way, there's no room for laziness, no room for tiredness, there's no room for boredom. Always you're engaging. Always you're active. always there's some sort of excitement in life. There's no thing of taking a break. Taking a break itself is just shifting activities. As was being shared in an earlier Vakyartha Sadas, taking a break is shifting activities. It's shifting activism. It's shifting the flavor of excitedness. So this is the main click that Ranoshan wanted to share. Nithyanandam.
Nithyanandam. Thank you, Ranoshan. Yes, actually, you're right about the truth. Then the truth that Swamiji is telling, the satya that Swamiji is saying, that you are super consciousness. And one thing when we realize that the boredness, tired, laziness are so influential. I'm not going to even call them powerful. I'm going to call them influential. So they're so influential that they become your truth. They become the truth that you live by. The delusion will be such that it's not you. You will think it is very logical, but it is on the outside. Other people will be pointing out to you and saying that is laziness. But you'll think you're being practical and logical thinking that way. If I don't get sleep now, if I don't sleep like this now, then I'll miss sleep later. Then I'll be tired later. Then I'll be irritated later. Then I'll get angry later. So you're thinking very practically, but other people are pointing at you and saying, no, that is laziness. And then you are having to look in them, and then you need to think of the higher truth. The higher truth that, yes, I am super consciousness. So from you are the examples that I had in Pralay, where I had to literally drag myself out of laziness and make something happen a few times for some of the rituals in especially during the Navaratri and little bit before the Navaratri when we were doing the Pandakal festival. It was such that nothing was ready for the next day morning. We had to finish one ritual in the night, and the next day morning at 4 o'clock, Pandakal has to be ready. Pandakal is a ritual where we install a bamboo stem in the ground, bamboo stick in the ground, declaring the inauguration of the festivities. So it is made for the Nityananeshwar Brahmotsavam, and Pandakal is done in late September, where the stick is installed and we do the ritual in the morning. So it was about in the night, late the previous night, some other ritual was happening, and that ended very late. And I got to know, and the other people, fortunately, around then, that time the ecosystem around had told me, look, there's nobody else there. There are people who are telling, look, there's nobody else there. It is, if we have to burn the midnight oil, it is worth burning it now, so that we're not late and the things are not delayed in the morning. So this message came to me, and this support was given. And I took that as a message as a waking up. Like, yeah, if I don't move, if I don't burn out the midnight oil now, tomorrow morning, we will not be able to hit the correct time and do the ritual at the correct muhurtam. So the night I had to, I had to say, okay, we are doing this for Swamiji. We need to do it for Swamiji. Can we do a little bit of sacrifice for Swamiji? Can we do, not even a little bit of sacrifice, it's just like saying, why are we here? Why am I even here? What is the point of running this? Am I here to continuously fight and against the whole thing and say, no, I am only here to protect so that I have correct sleep in the night? No, I am here to know that these sacrifices and these particular things are worth it. Because at the end of it, you'll have a correct result. And in that way also, you learn that there is more capability and more tremendous, more energy. And that way, I was able to actually be awake and energetic the whole night. It was not a suffering at all. It was, I was able to make the whole, whatever needs to happen. And I don't know, that whole thing resulted in me moving. When I moved and did the necessary, or even what I felt was hard, even a small, I felt as a big sacrifice, maybe it looks like a small sacrifice of sleep. But when I decided to move out of my way to make something happen, move out of my logic and my own practicality, I realized many other people noticed that and also fell in and decided that, okay, this also we can do, this also we can step up. So the alignment back into Swamiji, actually the actual thought that helped me continue that night, what I had to do was it was a physical task. You had to go literally dig the hole 3 feet into the ground and pull it out, and then clear the entire area of the all the shrubbery, and then clean up, and then get this pandaka ready and get the ritual items, everything, and then only went, got, took a bath, came back, and then by the time I came back, we had to do Uttamottama Seva, finish Uttamottama Seva. In the middle of Uttamottama Seva, I had to go and do Pandakal. Everything was arranged, and people supported and got things ready. But I remember having this one thought in my mind that it was out of my normal logic. The things that I need, at least an hour I need, at least 10 minutes I need, at least 5 minutes I need of sleep. Those thoughts were continuously coming up, but I just felt no. There's that has to be done, or that has to be done, that has to be done. Rather than thinking that has to be done, only I am there, I have to do, and this is overwhelming. I had to think. I had thought. The only thought that was repeating inside me was, Swamiji is there. Swamiji has done so much of these kind of tyaga. Swamiji has done tremendous amount of tyaga to build this whole sangha. Can't I just sacrifice this little sleep? So for me, that was the thing that pulled me back and said, yeah, I can do. There's more I can stretch. There's more I can do. There's more I can stretch. Right? Because as far as me being in the we being Adinavasis, our life is to be with him and like him. Exactly like him. And that is why I decided to come here, and that's why I decided to be here. So remembering that and coming back to that, so much opportunity and tremendous opportunity is given. So yeah, thanks everyone for having listening for that, and just wanted to share that example.
Thank you so much, Raja Maharaj. So we'll go ahead and Murli Ayya to share his thoughts about this. His powerful cognitions and thought currents. You can go ahead, Ayya.
Thank you, Maharaj. In a way, I should say that whatever I wanted to share was actually shared by already all the people here. And to start off with Ashutosh Nanda, I actually resonated with a lot of things that he had said. It is a practicing, his way of thinking, thinking through things, re-looking at things, where I'm missing, and going back to Swamiji and asking him for guidance. That's what clicked with him, and that's what I think I should also do. How the pralaya had affected us. See, till this moment when all this vacancy happened, I was thinking that I had never missed a day of puja, so still what is wrong? But now I understand that I was doing it out of boredom and out of tiredness, and I should not have done, I should have actually completed the boredom before I in the puja. Now, initially during the introduction, I used to say that I will share all the miracles that happened to me. That I think this is a forum for that now. Now, even before Swamiji talked about any materialization, vibhuti materialization, even before they talked about, even before he introduced this term called practicing the presence of God, I understood that. When I come to think back what I've had at the time, it is actually my practicing the presence of God that even helped in materializing the vibhuti. See, when the Guru Puja started at the advent of the time, in the Adikalash, there was the practice was that the mantra meaning was given so that the listeners can internalize and understand the meaning of the ritual they are doing. So when this practice was really helpful for me, because when I did the mantras with the understanding of the meaning, and I cognized myself offering the bouquet, self offering the food, I cognized that Swamiji was eating in front of me, taking the water and washing his hands and mouth in front of me. I cognized that, and that is what actually helped me in the miracles, and the puja moment was really, really kicked with the oneness, helped me establish the oneness, and that is why even I think this vibhuti materialization is happening. And today, when I see that I thought I was doing only the physical action, and that the space was missing. As a kid, I knew that only chanting the mantras was not going to help me. As I said today, at the beginning of the Vakya service today, I said I learned the hard way about what was missing in my life, and that was spiritual strength. I think I had gone back to the space. that I'm lacking the spiritual strength. I think I should complete with that. I should complete with my boredom, my laziness and tiredness and all that. And I should realign myself with practicing the presence of God in terms of how Swamiji puts it. And talk to him, and as Maharaj was saying, I think I am being very genuine. I think I am being very logical. And it is the other person who is at fault. Now I think I should take out time, more time to sit with Swamiji and internalize whatever he had taught, more think through him, think through the problem and remember him and prioritize this puja time. And from that intensity, I think I should look at whatever I am going through so that some solution will manifest. So I should thank Swamiji for this podcast opportunity. And if Maharaj and other viewers would have noticed, I think because of this click that had happened today, I had started levitating. So I think something had really clicked inside me, even without my own logic realizing it. So thank you, Swamiji, for giving me this opportunity and making me get this click. So I'll surely spend more time with you. I'll surely meditate on you more, spend time with you more and prioritize this time with you more. And from that intensity, let me go through my life situation so that some situation does click with me. So, prioritizing Swamiji time is something that should happen from me, is what the click I get from the sadhas that had happened today. I'll surely do it. I'll surely do it. Thank you, Swamiji. Thank you, Maharaj.
Thank you so much, Aya. So, we also have Sanjay ji. We can go ahead, Aya.
Nithyanandam. So, yeah, reading that statement first, in fact, the experience here has been slightly different. So, during this pranayama, I've actually felt a deeper connection. And I've been able to connect in a way that I wasn't previously. And as I'm thinking about that, it feels like it's because I feel like I have more time. There were fewer distractions. So the feeling here is actually quite different. And it's now more of a concern and I'm thinking rather of what happens when things go back to a like the old way or the new way. So when things open up and those potential distractions are back, what happens then? And I think this is where, again, today's satsang has felt really powerful because it feels like Swamiji is taking us, reminding me of some of the fundamentals that remember first, the first principle is super consciousness. Come from that space first. And it's a very useful thing to rehear, to re-internalize, especially coming from this space where there's been this really deep emotional reconnection. And then this almost concern of, okay, but what when all the other external factors come in? So it's a very pertinent reminder actually to say, hold on, those external things are just that. They are external. Cement that inner space. You are super consciousness, and kind of live life from that space first. So that's been the cognition here. I've experienced it in that way. So just to expand that in a small way, so due to what I consider to be time restrictions or feeling tiredness, there were certain things I wouldn't do or I'd miss or I'll do more weekly, even in terms of following the right foods. And then suddenly during pralaya, there is an availability of time. There is availability of just being in my own space and doing things like that. So yeah, I suppose it's been a slightly different experience.
Than that. Yeah, I just flipped the lights.
Nithyananda? You can go ahead and continue. Yes. Nithyananda, am I audible? Yes.
Yes, Maharaj, you are audible.
Yes, Sanjay, you can go ahead and continue. Okay. Hello, am I audible?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Thank you so much, Sanjayji, for your sharing your powerful cognitions and thought currents.
Yes, yeah. Actually, what you're feeling also, we also had the same thing. We also felt when Swamiji said first that the delay, the pralaya was a time where you could have looked in when we had a what all are the things that pralaya had given us, and we had all shared in that vakyasas that day that yeah, actually pralaya had given us a lot of space to open up, and the time was there to also look in, and also that. But yes, then Swamiji, I would say, shocked us with the next statement saying, look, there are things that are there maybe settled inside you, that the decisions you made inside pralay, that is still pralay that exists inside you that you need to correct. Unless you correct those, pralay is still existing. So take your time to look into that. So we've come to this, even into this contemplation. And in doing so, we have looked in and saw more about where it is that we can really correct. And I'm also seeing that if I was given tremendous amount of time in pralay and given a tremendous amount of time to look in, why would I sit and do just look in and work only on emoting and feeling connection with Swamiji as far as just from an emotional level? These powerful cognitions that Swamiji is giving now about your super consciousness and all that, how come I didn't cherish this back then? If I had cherished this back then I don't know what if I had the time to cherish this back then. So we get really deluded when we think there's whole time, a lot of time in front of us. And then what we choose to do when we have time, what we choose to do when all this time is given it to us, those are the things that Swamiji is trying to bring awareness to us and make us look in. So yeah, thank you for your sharing. And
yes, so just like to thank all the panelists once for joining us here today. Thank you so much for coming today for today's Vakyata Satas. All the viewers, those of you who are watching us here, and in all the panelists as well, for all of us actually, whatever we have spoken about the Guru, about how we can rekindle our feeling connection with Him, bring us more and more closer to oneness with Him, to integrity with Him, the best way for all of us to do this is to let Him itself give a solution for this as well by coming and attending the Paramashivam program from January 7th onwards. Swamiji is giving a breakthrough to the Paramashivam program, which He had introduced back in 2018. And since then, the Paramashivam program has been conducted. So for the program itself, Swamiji is going to give an entirely different breakthrough, a super conscious breakthrough for the whole program. Those who, if you're interested, if something which we have said clicked with you and you have the urge to attend the program, you can go to the link being projected below, www.paramashivoham.org, and register yourself for the Paramashivam program. With this, it's time to enter into Nitya Satsang. Please sit with your head, neck and spine in a straight line. Bring your awareness into your Ananda Gandha. Visualize Swamiji sitting there in your Ananda Gandha as Paramashiva with the 25 heads and 50 hands. Now, allowing the mantra to vibrate throughout your entire body, start chanting the Mahavakya, Om Nithyananda Paramashivoham. Om Nithyananda Paramashivoham. Om
Nithyananda Paramashivoham.
Is meditation connecting with the divine? With your eyes open is darshan. Come, let us all now move from meditation to darshan slowly.